Hello and welcome to Launch Excel. I'm Victor, and in today's video, we're going to have a look at a viewer request from Svetlana. So Svetlana, a couple days ago, asked how to delete rows if I want to sort by more than one column and delete rows that match more than two or three of my filters. As an example, she says, I have a sheet that in column J, I have text DS, CD, SS, WB. So down here, column J, DS, CD, SS, WB. Now this could be in any order, I guess, and the VBA that does this, the macro code that does this, doesn't care about what order this is in. And it could be many more rows down below, but this is just for illustration's purpose. So in column D, you have blanks or different texts. So in column D here, we've got blanks here and non-blank. So that non-blank could be any text whatsoever. This is blank, 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 and blank. And what Svetlana would like to do, if I read this correctly, is she'd like to delete all the rows that had CD in column J. So CD, this one, this one, this one, this one. These four have CD in column J and match only the blanks from column D. So blanks and CD, this is the ones I've highlighted yellow. So those two she'd like to delete, he or she, sorry, Svetlana. I presume you're a she, but I don't know. So he or she would like to delete. I would not like to delete rows that have, for example, text WB in column J and blanks in column D. So what we'll do is we shall take a look at using VBA, which is Visual Basic for Applications in Excel. And this is a way to automate your Excel programs if you're not already familiar with it. It's a really powerful tool and it's underutilized by many people. So here's an example of how to use it. And as a solution, we're going to use Excel VBA, which is Visual Basic for Applications, to apply an autofilter to the data range and then delete the rows we do not want to keep. So this is going to delete the visible rows. So I'm going to have one solution there. I'm also going to do the opposite. So instead of deleting the visible rows, I'm also going to show you how to delete the hidden rows. And that's slightly more complicated. It uses a different construct in VBA, but I'll show you both ways. So if you want to keep the rows that are blank in column D and have CD in column J, what we'll do is apply an autofilter to find the blank cells in column D and the cells with CD in column J, and then we'll delete the hidden rows. Okay, onto the VBA. Here on the left, I've got the Excel VBA editor open. To access this, you press Alt and F11 as a keyboard shortcut. And once you're in here, you can see in this spreadsheet, I have something called a subroutine. This is a macro, piece of code that you run, and what it does is going to delete the CD blanks. So delete all rows with CD in column J that also have blanks in column D. Now I'll give you a demonstration on the right here how it works. This is the actual worksheet. It's called working, and when I press one of these buttons, it's going to run on a macro. So this first one will run macro 1, delete blank CD. If I press that, before I press it actually, I'll just highlight the rows which are blank and CD. So here and here, I will highlight them in yellow. So you should expect to see these gone, but none of the others gone. So there's one, let's see how many rows are there. There are 13 rows there. And when I press that delete, we see the yellow rows have disappeared and we're left with 11 rows. Okay, so that worked. I'm gonna reset the sheet now and head back to the left. So this delete CD blanks macro, how does it work? Well, you'll notice I've broken this down using the comments in green here with an apostrophe or quote mark at the beginning, just a single one. And what I've done with these comments is explain the steps we go through. So the first step is to reset the sheet, and then we apply the autofilter to the range using this set of lines. And then we finally delete the visible rows. So this is the line you need to use to delete visible rows. We're just using a range, and we're just going to offset it just to avoid deleting the headers. We're going to go to special cells, open bracket, Excel, cell type visible, close bracket, dot entire row, dot delete. So all that does is it takes special cells that are cell type visible, anything that's still visible after you do the filter. It's going to take the entire row and it's going to delete it. So I'll step through this line by line. F8 is the shortcut for running through line by line. You can also access that through debug and step into this F8. So I press F8 and you see the yellow, that's where we're executing, that's the next line. So I've just declared a couple of variables. We're going to call this reset sheet. Let me just jump over that. So debug and step over that. So it's going to run that and it's going to clear it, but we're not going to step through all the lines of that. So this is the meat of it. So we're going to set this auto filter to the data range. With this RNG at the moment is nothing. We're going to set it to be range A1. So we're looking at this sheet here, A1 and dot current region. So it's going to take everything that's bounded by these blank rows and columns. So it's going to take that whole area from A1 to J14. So I press F8. And then it's going to check if the auto filter mode is on, then show all the data. That's not necessary now because there is no auto filter. We apply the range.auto filter using field 4, which is column D, field 4. And on that, we'll do the criteria and set the criteria to be equals nothing. So equals nothing is going to take all the blanks. And I press F8 there. You see it's filtered everything here that's blank. It's got no entries inside. So back to the VBA code. We've got range.auto filter, field 10, and criteria CD. So field 10, that's the 10th column. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Field is 10 and criteria 1 is CD. So when I press F8 over here on the left, on the right you should see it just filtered everything that just says CD. It ignores everything else. Everything else is hidden. So at this point, what we want to do is delete these rows, these two rows, because there's blanks in column D and CD in column J. So this is the line that's important. We've got the range, and I've offset this by one row just so that we don't delete that header row. And you might want to resize it as well. Depends if you have any data below. So I'm assuming there's nothing in row 15 or below. Then the special cells, Excel cell type visible, dot entire row dot delete. I'll press F8. And you see on the right, it's deleted those two rows. And the last step we'll do is this worksheet working. So this here, WKS underscore working, that's a code name. You can see on the left here, the code name for the worksheet is WKS underscore working. That's a short form in VBA. And the actual name that's visible to users is working. So on here in the code, I've just used the code name because the code name doesn't change in the user interface. You can only change the code name from the VBA editor. So this code name WKS underscore working dot autofilter mode, I've set it to false. And what that does on the right is it unfilters everything. So there you go. You see it's deleted those two rows with CD in column J and blanks in column D, and it's left everything else. Right, let's move on to macro 2. And in macro 2, what we're going to do is do the same filter, but instead of deleting the visible, what we're going to delete is the hidden rows. And as a quick example of how this works, let me come back to the right here, and I'll show you the ones that we deleted before this row and this row here. That was with delete blank CD. This time I'm going to press this button, keep blank CD. When I press it, what it does is it keeps those rows that are blank in column D and have CD in column J. Okay, so reset the sheet and have a look at the macro. Very similar structure. First step is to reset the sheet. Second step is to apply the auto filter to the data range. And the third step is to delete hidden rows this time instead of visible rows. So I'll run through this with F8, step into F8, F8. So I'll just step over this. Debug, step over, and set this RNG, this range object, to be equal to range A1.currentRegion as before. We'll check if the worksheet working has an auto filter on. It doesn't, so it just goes to endif. Now we're going to filter for field 4 and criteria is blank, and we're going to filter again for field 10, which is column J, criteria 1 is CD. So as before, we've reached the same positions before. In the previous one, what we did is deleted these two rows, row 7 and row 9, and then we unfiltered. This one, we're going to go and delete the hidden rows. So it's going to check for each my cell, and my cell is a range object. For each my cell in range.columns1.cells, so columns 1 is that first column here, and all those cells in columns 1, it's going to loop through those one by one, and it will check if my cell.entireRow.hidden, so if the whole row is hidden, then check if range underscore delete is nothing, then set the range delete to be my cell. Or else, if it already is something, it's going to set range underscore delete to be the union, the joining of the previous range delete and my cell. Basically what this does is it takes each cell one at a time, it checks if the row is hidden. If the row is hidden, it's going to add it to this range underscore delete. And after that, we're going to delete this range underscore delete and the entire row. So it's going to add cell by cell those cells which are hidden and then delete all of them later. So I'll press F8 here. That first one wasn't in, so end if. And this one, if my cell.entire, this is now on cell 2. Is that hidden? Yes, it is. So now it's hidden. The first thing it's going to check is this range delete nothing? That's basically saying, do I have any cells in this? So the answer is no. Okay, in that case, set the range delete to be equal to my cell, just to start it off. Okay, next we move on to cell 3. And is that hidden? Yes, it is. So it's going to go through this again. So is range delete nothing? No, it isn't, because it's already got a cell. It's going to jump to this else statement. Okay, so with else, what it's going to do is set this range delete to be what already exists there, which is the first cell, and the second cell. So it's going to combine those two ranges together. End if. And what I'll do is I'll now skip this through. It's going to loop through each of those cells, and it will be faster if I just go debug and run to cursor. Or you could also press Control F8. What it's going to do is run to that cursor line. Okay, so now it's gone through all those cells. It's picked out the ones which are hidden. And now it's going to do is check. If not range delete is nothing, that's a bit convoluted, but basically it's saying if the range delete has something inside it, then, and that's true in this case because there are cells in it, in that range, what it's going to do is delete the entire row of range delete. So at the moment, you might remember range underscore del, the range delete, the range to delete. It only consists of single cells in that first column because we had this range.columns1.cells. So it's just got this column 1 cells in it. What we're going to do is specify this dot entire row, which is going to specify the whole rows for each of those cells. And then we're going to delete. So press F8 on this to run that line. And we'll unfilter the worksheet. And you'll see on the right, this is what we're left with. We only have these two different rows remaining, the ones with blanks in column D and CD in column J. Right, we've come to the end of this video, and what I'd like you to do now is hit that like button down there, the one down in the just below this video. Hit the like button right now, and if you haven't hit the subscribe button, also hit the subscribe button. I'd love for you to be a subscriber so you can get more notifications when I create new videos like this. If you have any questions like this, please just leave a comment on YouTube and I will get to those comments. I hope I can use to reach as many people as possible. So I'll try to create more content that is based on your requests, and I'll do it to as wide an audience as I think I can. And if you want a copy of this workbook, you can get a copy of this workbook. A copy of this workbook is going to be available. I'm going to put it in the description just below the video. So I hope you enjoyed this video and stick around for more videos just like this. All right, see you soon. Thanks for watching. And for more tutorials on Excel and VBA, check out www.launchexcel.com.